A data logger needs a program to read sensors, store data, and do control. I'll be using Shortcut to generate a simple program. Shortcut is included with both LoggerNet and PC400. From the program category of the LoggerNet toolbar, select Shortcut. The program generator opens. Select Create New Program. Select the data logger model the program is for. I'll choose the CR1000X series. The first time I run Shortcut, I'm prompted for the first notch frequency. Choose 50 Hz for most of the world, 60 Hz for North America and parts of South America. After that, all programs will use the same setting. I can check or change the setting later from the program menu. Likewise, the first time I run Shortcut, I'm asked to select which group of sensor files will be displayed when creating a program. Campbell Scientific Incorporated, US, or Campbell Scientific Limited, UK. This setting, like the first notch frequency, can be changed later through the program menu item. Click Next. By default, the data logger battery voltage and wiring panel temperature are measured. It is good practice to keep these. I'm using a Type T thermocouple in my example. One of these is shipped with every data logger. If I don't have one, I can use another sensor that I do have. Thermocouples are temperature sensors, so I can either use the search bar to locate the thermocouple, or I can select the temperature icon and find it there. Specifically, it is a Type T thermocouple, so I select that here and add it to my sensor list by double-clicking or by clicking the arrow. I will use the default settings. If I wanted to change the name of the variable that stores the temperature measurement, I would change it here. Thermocouples require a reference temperature. For this tutorial, I'll be using the CR1000XE wiring panel temperature, PTEMP-C, as my reference. At this time, I can add additional sensors in the same way, or I can wire the sensor to my CR1000XE. The wiring diagram and text provided show where the sensor leads must be connected to the data logger wiring panel to take good measurements. Incorrect wiring or not following the diagram provided is a common new user error. It's good practice to remove power from the data logger before making changes to the wiring. Disconnect the USB cable. I attach my wiring to the data logger by opening the wiring terminals and inserting the wire, taking care to ensure the terminal clamps down on the conductor itself, not the insulation or colored part. When done, reapply power. Remember that a 12-volt power supply is needed to make measurements in the field, but power over USB is sufficient for data logger configuration. When I'm done adding and wiring sensors, I click Next. I'm then asked, how often should the CR1000X series measure its sensors? This is how often the data logger wakes up and takes measurements. For this tutorial, I'll set this to 1 second. Next, I'll enter a name for the first table. The name needs to start with a letter, cannot contain spaces, and can be up to 20 characters. I'll call mine 1 minute. This will become part of the file name of the data copied from the data logger to the computer. Now, set the data output storage interval. In this example, I want to store data every 1 minute, or 60 seconds. Since the default is 60, choose seconds as the units. I could also have changed the interval to 1 and used minutes. Notice that when I change the interval, this text changes to reflect the number of measurements that will be included in the storage interval. I would follow the same procedure to add other tables. In Shortcut, I can configure up to 10 tables for data storage. Next. Now I specify the data I want stored and later copied to a computer. I'll add measurements with processing to the table. Each minute, I'll have the data logger store the average air temperature. Since the data logger is taking 1 second measurements, this will be an average of 60 discrete measurements. Other measurements and processing are added in the same way. It is a good idea to store the minimum battery voltage. With the maximum and minimum outputs, I can also store the time that the maximum or minimum occurred. In this example, it would be which second in the 60 was the minimum. I'm not going to store the time. A sample records the latest measured value without any special processing. Other tables or output intervals are set up in a similar way. I'll demonstrate, but it's not necessary to follow along for this tutorial. When I'm done configuring the output, I click Finish and save the program. By default, it is saved to the C Campbell Sci SC Win folder. The program is checked for any errors or warnings. And if I've established communications to the data logger, I can send the program now. I'll select No and send the program later. It is good practice to collect the data from the CR1000XE before sending the program. I can do that through the Connect screen where I'll also send the program. Shortcut provides a summary, and under the Advanced tab I can see the CR Basic program and other information. If I need to go back to my program in the future to make changes, I can. I will close Shortcut when I've finished and saved my program. Now that I have my program generated, I'll go back to the Connect screen and send the program to the CR1000XE.